In this episode, I'll show you how to generate an email with an attachment and use a Salesforce Quick Action to actually edit that email before sending it out to your recipients and contacts and customers. The only thing you have to do is click the button, so the email will be generated together with our quote attachment, and everything will be filled in correctly, nicely into our Salesforce Quick Action. Now, how we go about setting that up? First step is we're going to create a quick action in Salesforce. From our Object Manager, we are going to go to the opportunity. And on the opportunity, I'm going to generate a quick action. It's just a normal quick action of the type send email. Okay, send email. I'm going to call it PDF Butler. Or I'm just going to call it send email, by PDF Butler. Okay, and that's it. Save my quick action. And then click the save button again. So we're not going to change anything on the layout. So I'll leave this window open because later on we will need the name of this quick action. Now, the next step is we're going to add it to the page layout. Okay, so this is the page layout of our opportunity. And I'm going to go to my lightning actions, and there should be something called send email by PDF Butler. And indeed, I can add it just right here. Click the save button. And that's it. So now I'm going to go to the next step, and the next step is we're going to go to PDF Butler, and in PDF Butler we're going to generate a pack. In this demo, I'm not going to show you how to generate the email.config because there's another video on that. That video will be in our comments, so you can easily look into that one as well. And I'm also not going to show you how to create the quote documents because, yeah, this is, of course, the basis of PDF Butler. So for generating the email and generating the quote documents, please look into our academy for more information. Now I'm just going to set up, I'm just going to act like I already have that information, and I'm going to set it up from scratch. Okay, going to go for a new PDF Butler pack. I'm going to call it send email by PDF Butler. Okay, it's going to be active. The leading one has to be the mail that I'm going to send out because this is the item that I want to generate via PDF Butler first. Now, next up, I'm going to add an extra.config. So this is the attachment that I want to send out, and that's our car quote document. The order is just one. This is just if you have multiple attachments, but okay, that's fine for now. And then I'm gonna go for an actionable. I'm gonna create a new actionable, and it has to be of type email.config for quick action. Okay, I'm gonna click the next. So this is gonna call send email. I'm going to ignore that because it's linked to the pack. The class, I'm going to put the class in the comments of the YouTube video and also on our academy, so it can just be copy-pasted. Then, okay, put the class here. It's, of course, after the generation, so it's active. I'm not going to specify an org-wide email address here in this one. I'm just going to say, well, it's the if it's empty, then it will take actually the name of the current user, the email address of the current user, or it will be sent out as the current user. So for this one, I'm going to go for the primary contact. That's an a data source to select a primary contact on my opportunity. So this is this person over here. You can use any data source, of course, but this is just the data source how I described it. Then the action object is our opportunity. So that's the object I'm going to call it from. And then the action name is actually the quick action we have just created. So I'm going to copy paste that name from here. And I think it was this one. Yep, that's the one I've just created. So it's the name, not the label. Make sure to use the name and not the label of the quick action. And then I'm going to fill it in right here. Okay, everything is done. Everything is set up. So if I now refresh my, first of all, my opportunity, I will have hopefully the extra quick action here. That's correct. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this component to use the pack that I've just created, and then it will fill in the data into this quick action. So I'm going to go to edit page, copy the ID of my pack. I do that from the header bar, from the URL bar. Then while the edit page is loading, okay, go to the activity tab, take this component. If you don't have a component, you can just drag and drop your new component directly on here, of course. So you can just drag it here and make sure that this one is used. I already had one, so I'm just going to reuse that one. As you can see, it already uses my locales and language settings and everything. So that's why it's just easy to reuse. Okay, I'm going to give it sent by PDF Butler edit before sending. So this is just the name of the pack, so it can be easily read on the screen what actually happens. Okay, everything should be great now. And if I click the save button, change is saved. And if I go back, then normally when I run this pack, so now everything should be set up. I have added my pack to this lightning component of PDF Butler. So it will generate my email, it will generate my document, and then push everything by the actionable, push everything to my quick action over here. So if I click the button email, it will generate the email, the documents, and as you can see, it now everything has been pushed to this quick action. Of course, when in my email, actionable, if I would have added more recipients in the two, if I would have added recipients for CC, all of those would be shown as well. The cool thing is I directly have my document now attached here, so I can see it in the preview. Okay, the preview is not ready yet, but this, as you can see, the document is attached here. So yeah, looking good. I can now go ahead and say, well, was great to talk to you. Hope to hear you soon. Enjoy the week. So I can just change my everything here, as you can see, and make sure everything is set correctly. Yeah, I even have my Grammarly access here. So yeah, that's great. So no errors to be shown there.